Pinu-screen pa talaga. May message ka namin, gigest ka namin.
May jaywalking. Yep.
Last Sunday, you could just feel that yung landscape ng PBA, maraming magbabago. We had the 46th PBA Gatorade draft, and now we're waiting for the rookies to come in and really bring it in the PBA sa pagsisimula ng ating Philippine Cup.
Ito man naman, there was 86 hopefuls na talagang nangarap, nagdasal, nag-apply. Actually, 97 naging 86. And 65, narinig yung pangalan nilang tinawag. Merong 4 special Gilas draft, automatic. And then may 61 na tinawag ang pangalan dito sa PBA. Of course, not everybody's gonna get signed. Pero the work begins, especially if you're a fourth rounder and beyond or a third rounder and beyond. Mas mahirap yung tatahakin mo. Pero syempre, ito na yung pinakamasarap dyan. Ano? The work begins. Unahin natin pagkwentuhan, etong 4 na to, Carlo. These 4, their names were called last Sunday, and then kahapon, Monday, pumasok na to sa bubble sa Kalamba.
Ito, alam na nila yung mga, at least yung gagawin nila in the next couple of years kasi nga until they're released by the Samahang Basketball ng Pilipinas to their mother teams, eh doon muna sila magseservisyo para sa bayan. Terra Firma Jeep picking up Jordan Heading, Northport Batang Pier nakuha si William Navarro, si Tsadi Rangel with the NLEX Road Warriors, and JD Tongkab falls with the TNT Tropangiga. So those 4 would be good additions to the Gilas Pilipinas team pool.
Yan nga, no? So different types of players will be part of that pool. Yung 4 na yan will be part of that pool. And then kalaunan nga, may ari ng rights nila pagdating nila ng PBA. It should be interesting times ahead para dito sa Young Gilas Pilipinas natin. Angelo Kwame, on the third and final reading sa Senate, na-approve na. So now, that was yesterday, if I'm not mistaken, kapon yun, di ba? Sure. So now, dadali na sa Malacanang yon first signature na ng presidente. And then, Kwame can finally become a naturalized Filipino and a naturalized player at that.
At kung hindi pirmahan within 30 days, it will automatically lapse into law, no? So hindi kailangan yung pirma necessarily. It could just pass into law in the next 30 days. So excited tayo na makasama na itong si Ange Kwame in the national team because he's been training with them for so long. Tagal na nung training niya, di ba? Dun sa mga windows pa lang, those games against Thailand, he was already there putting in the work, knowing the system, learning under Coach Tab, knowing his teammates. Eh, gusto na natin makita kung ano talaga yung kakayahan niya, kung ano yung kaya niyang ibigay sa national team. And we might just see that in the next window.
Yun nga, no? What he brings to the basketball court, eh yun yung talagang aantayin natin, aantabayanan natin at susuportahan natin or di ba bibigyan natin ng criticism kung kulang. Pero ang pinaka-importante, as we've all heard of and known and I've observed and kahit na nag-guess natin siya dito, ay yung personality na itong batang to. Napakabait, hard worker, humble. Eh, lalo na ngayon, this week, pumutok din kahapon yung balita, may isang college import, eh, papadeport na. Yun yung differences ng personality, no? Kaya ito talaga pinush ng SBP at sinuporta na talagang pinush na ito maging si Kwame maging naturalized player natin dahil hindi lang yung laki niya, hindi lang yung skills niya, what he is or who he is as a person, eh pwedeng-pwede na mapagyabang na pwedeng Pilipino rin to.
Kaya nga, excited din tayo dun sa 4 na naidagdag sa Gilas Pilipinas pool. May tanong dito, Maguno, si Eric Urbistondo, anong status ni na Isaac Go and company na na-draft sa PBA nakuha ng Gilas? Stay pa rin ba sa Gilas? Yes, that mm-hmm. is the case. They will be staying with Gilas until they are released to their mother team. So, for many of them, that will be until 2023, no? After the FIBA Basketball World Cup that we are hosting. Doon pa lang sila makakapaglaro for their respective teams.
And from what we've heard, isa-isa na rin silang papasok this week into that bubble. Meron lang mga minor injuries o may mga inaasikaso pang kailangan na sikasuhin dahil tanda natin pagpasok mo sa bubble, eh kailangan nando doon ka lang. Wala na namang labasan yan. Magka-quarantine ka. And then, doon ka na. Hanggang sa magkaroon kayo ng break o dumiretso na kayo. Doon sa Clark bubble naman. Kasi matagal pa eh, no? Ano wala ba itong?
Wala pa ngang final schedule yata.
Sa June pa eh. Sa June pa yung qualifiers. Pero mauuna pa yun kesa dito sa yung OQT naman, di ba?
That's correct. Naghihintay rin tayo ng balita about yung mga bagong schedule ng Gilas Pilipinas.
Para for Heading, Navarro, Tungkab, and Rangel, good luck sa inyo. And hopefully you make the entire country proud with how you're going to be representing the Philippines.
Shoutouts muna tayo, Magu. Magandang hapon kay James Adrian Orogo Valiente, si Brian Yaj, si Rain Francis, John Kenneth Tumbaga, again, si Godfrey Goles na sharer, Christian Clemente, Daryl Buenoobra, again, si Tus Pasquil, at si John Vincent Estrella at Carl Reyes. Maraming salamat po sa inyong panonood. Let's move now, Magu, to that.
Kulang mga shoutout mo eh. Pinaka-importante kailang batiin natin, Miss Denise Tan, nakatutok din sa atin yan. Magandang hapon sa'yo, ma'am.
Hapon, ma'am Denise. Ito, Magu, let's check out the first round.
Yan.
Yung unang lima, I think a lot of us got it right. Sa mga mock drafts, especially when we found out that TNT was getting the fourth pick. Kasi nung una, nag-iisip pa tayong kukunin ba ng NLEX si Mikey Williams for another guard or will they decide to get a big. But when TNT got that fourth pick, parang naging lock na si Mikey Williams at the number four spot.
Kasi if the pick remained with the NLEX, you know they still have Kiefer. So, and they have Kevin Alas there. So baka kumuha sila ng swing or ano. Pero nung napunta na nga sa TNT yung pick na yan, that is why the move was made, is para nga makuha itong si Mikey Williams. You know what this reminds me of?
Mm.
Coach Chot Reyes din dumiskarte nito way back in the day. Jason Castro. Diba? That pick, that Jason Castro pick, third overall, if we're not mistaken, belonged to the San Miguel Beermen. Akalain mong tinraid ng TNT si Jay Washington, who was a two-time... Hindi, sa San Miguel na siya nag-BPC. Pero grabe, ang bigat din ni Jay Washington at that time. Siya ang tinraid to get the third overall pick, which ended up as Jason Castro. Okay, si Jay Washington had a great career at San Miguel, two-time BPC yan. Pero Jason Castro was also Jason Castro sa kabila, di ba?
Oh, naging 40 greatest PBA players si Jason Castro. So you can...
Back-to-back pinakamahusay na gwardiya sa Asia lang naman, di ba?
Tama yan, Magu. So again, no surprises. Joshua Monzon, Jamie Malonzo, Calvin Oftana, Mikey Williams, and Leonard Santillan. At the number 6 spot, you felt that you could have gone to Larry Muyang or Ben Adamos. So it depended dun sa taste nung kukuha na team. But it was Alaska and they decided to get Ben Adamos.
I think they really, Coach Jeff was really looking for the ceiling. Kasi may Abu Trotter gan eh. Medyo undersized forward din. Abu Trotter 6'3", Muyang 6'4". So parang si Vic Manuel lang din. 6'4", 6'5", si Musselman, di ba? So now they just really wanted to mas lumaki yung frontline. So tandaan natin, you're still gonna have to go through Junmar. Junmar is gonna be back. And then Greg Slaughter is gonna be getting his minutes over at Northport. Mm-hmm. So you need somebody na kayang tumapat doon sa dalawang yon.
Again, Larry Muyang landing at number 7. A great selection for Phoenix Super LPG. Should be, you know, an automatic member of that already. Good rotation sa pagitan ni na Justin Chua, Perkins, Vic Manuel, dagdag mo pa si Larry Muyang. So, maganda na yung rotation ng big man ni Coach Topex Robinson.
Ito naman sa number 8, Carlo. How do you like this pick? Ito yung pinag-usapan a month and a half ago dahil ito nga yung pinaka-package para dito kay CJ Perez. It was the number 8 pick. It was a chance to pick for a second time in the first round ng Terra Firma. And they went big. Laput. Itong si James Dado Laput pa nga yata. Yung totoong full name.
Pado diba? Yep. Ako, Magu, honestly, between him and Troy Reich, mag-iisip ako ng, I would have thought it over. Dahil we've seen more of Troy Reich. Mas marami tayong nakita sa kanya eh. But of course, syempre, alam naman natin in basketball, pag mas matangkad ng konti, you will get the benefit of the doubt. The coaches will often think that you're a project, that they can make you better. So they're betting na yung ceiling nitong si James Laput mas mataas sa ceiling ni Troy Reich, even if Reich might be the better player right now.
There have been projects in the past, some of them okay, some of them hindi. you just don't want to be on the negative side of it. Like, top of my mind, I remember Sam Eman. Diba? He was a project. Grabe yung pagkakapik sa kanya, but it never really panned out for him. Maybe hindi lang siya nag-fit talaga sa San Miguel during that time. And really never found a team na makakagamit sa kanya ng, for an extended period of time. Hopefully for Laput and Terra Firma, it works out.
May tanong dito, Magu. Diego Verhel de Dios, sabi niya, do you guys agree with Phoenix and Terra Firma getting Muyang and Laput over Pasaol? Na alam ko yung Meralco, sobrang kinatuwa that Pasaol was available for them at the ninth pick.
When you think about it, Alvin Pasaol, if he went to Phoenix, you've already got Matthew Wright. He's got that locked up. Mapa-dos, mapa-tres sa posisyon. And then he's got, of course, the people around him already. And yung kailangan talaga netong Phoenix was more muscle inside. Of course, they've got the muscle man already. Pero you can, like you said, kanina lang, you can never go wrong with size. Kung sa Terra Firma naman, nandoon na yung Roosevelt Adams, nandoon na yung Joshua Monzon. And yung Roosevelt Adams, I truly believe we have not seen what he can really do on the PBA stage. He started to get hot late in that PBA bubble, pero hindi pa yon yung kakayanan talaga na Roosevelt Adams. So kung pinasok mo yung Alvin Pasaol, baka lalong masastiming yung dapat na growth na ni Roosevelt Adams at this juncture. I like that he went to Meralco dahil we saw it in the bubble too. Every once in a while, parang nawiwindang yung opensa na itong Meralco. Kaya naman talagang nagpakita dyan. Si Aaron Black, si Travis Jackson. Nakita natin yung impact nila off that bench. May panaka-naka. Nakita natin doon. Pero now you've got somebody like Alvin Pasaol. He'll be coming off that bench. He'll probably be relieving Chris Newsom or somebody. Diba? Or some of those other starters. Solid na solid. I think it's a win-win for all three. Win-win situation for all three of them.
I agree. Para sa akin lang, I would have enjoyed watching Alvin Pasaol play for Coach Topex Robinson. Yun lang yun sa akin. That's something that I imagine could happen if Coach Topex can unleash the full potential nitong si Alvin Pasaol. Would have been really nice to see. But again, Larry Muyang eh. That's a legit PBA power forward. So if you get that opportunity to scoop him up, and looking down the road, Magu, looking maybe next year and the year before that, I don't think there are a lot of bigs coming into the PBA. So this was the perfect time to get someone like Larry Muyang.
And you don't see somebody that size that can windmill. Yun yung tuwan-tuwa kami ni Dom eh. This guy, alam mong merong hang time, merong tira sa labas, merong power move sa poste, pero for somebody that size to windmill, with all due respect to the bigs we have, sina Bo, sina Kinyahan, they can dunk. They can all dunk. I've seen it in person. Hindi lang nila ginagawa madalas sa game, pero to have that windmill in your arsenal, that's just spectacular. Diba? He can bring spectacular things.
Magu, napag-usapan natin si Pasaol. Magnolia getting a guard in Jerick Ahanmisi. Were you surprised?
I think they went for best available talent at this juncture. Yeah. And of course, tandaan natin, they just lost one of their key rotation guys the last year and a half. Hindi pa umabot na year and a half. No? Si, conference and a half in Chris Banchero. He's gonna have to fight for minutes over there. Kita naman natin, kahit yung minutes si Banchero nun, limited. Dahil ang pinakamabigat minutes sa gwardiya sa Magnolia, if I'm not mistaken again, Carlo, si Mark Barroca. Mm-hmm. Andy Mark Barroca got the most minutes, and then Paul Lee. Mm-hmm. And then of course, meron ka pang Gio Halalon doon. Yep. Meron ka pang Justin Melton. Ahanmisi, he's gonna be in a good spot. That is a storied franchise, but he's gonna have to earn his minutes.
Ako slightly surprised because of the availability again of Troy Reich, because akala ko Magnolia would still take the opportunity to get a big, pero nakausap ko si Coach Chito Victolero after, immediately after that draft. Sabi niya, yes, initially they were looking at a big, lalo na nung nandun pa sila sa number 6, because you could have gotten Muyang or Adamos or Santillan, kung sino man yung mahulog sa'yo. But they thought that trading for Calvin Abueva will solve that. Kaya naman na willing sila to part with the 6th pick. They went down to 10th. And again, Magu, going back to your point earlier, best available talent was Jerick Ahanmisi.
May isa pa akong angulo. Ako sa akin lang to, unofficial, sa loob lang ng coconut ko, paminsan-minsan, may tumbleweed lang na dumadaan dyan. Pero dahil hindi big yung kinuha nila Coach Chito Victolero, Ping Riz, may lugar pa si Ping, may lugar pa si Kuya Ping. Hindi big yung kinuha eh. Pwede pa mag-ping, di ba? We don't know what's gonna happen, but akala ko nga madudula si Coach RG no, ano, baka may alam eh. Hinuhuli ko eh, di ba, nung Sunday, pero wala rin yatang alam.
Siyempre,
I don't know.
Anyway,
that leaves a spot for Ping, and I want to see Ping back.
I think we're all biased for Mark Pingris. Lahat naman siguro tayo mapa-fan ka ng Magnolia or hindi. You have to appreciate everything that Mark Pingris has done for the PBA and for Philippine basketball.
Yeah.
And give him a proper exit.
As a whole, eh, not just the PBA, not just his squad, not just his squads. Nakakatatlong team na po yan. Nanggaling ng Air 21 nung araw, then tong Pure Foods, and then nag-San Miguel, and then bumalik dito sa Pure Foods, which is now Magnolia. You want to see him off into the sunset the proper way, the way legends are supposed to be sent off. Diba? I want to see that. Not a glorified farewell tour or anything. Leave him there competing because that's the only way Ping will have it. Si Ping, iiwan niya lahat dyan. Iiwan niya lahat sa sahig. If we see it. Nangangampan niya, no?
May comment dito, Magu. Sabi ni Rambo Raval, Rivas should retire. He should give his spot to younger players. Ang tanong ko dyan, bakit? What does he owe to anyone? You saw what he did in the PBA bubble. You saw how important he was for the Magnolia Hotshots. And if he remains effective, bakit siya aalis? Bakit siya magre-retire? I don't get it.
Two parts. Two things I want to stress. You stress the word effective. As long as the guy's effective, yun yung una. Pero sa akin, mas importante, well, I guess, just as important. If he's willing to put the work in, and he has been putting the work in, that's why he's effective. Magkasama, it goes hand in hand. So regardless if you're 40, 35, 25, 45, 50 years old, kung somebody's got to take your spot from you. Diba? If feeling ng management na ikaw pa rin ang magiging effective doon sa spot na yan, and you're putting the work in anyway, why not? Pagka dinaan mo na lang sa veterano ko, hindi ko kailangan mag-insayo, ibang usapan yon. But as far as what we've been hearing, the guy puts the work in. And as you mentioned, Carlo, we've seen how effective he is. Mm-hmm. Why not? Di ba?
Mag-uot number 11, Troy Reich for Northport. Perfect substitute pag magpapahinga si Greg Slaughter. Yeah?
Troy Reich, pwedeng alongside din eh. Because you keep him there. Yeah. You remember how they rotated Stan Hardinger, Anthony, and the import back then? Pwedeng ganun eh. You leave Reich there with Anthony too. Sean Anthony would just be going nuts down low. And then Troy Reich sa labas and vice versa. And then if you leave one or both of them with Slaughter there, si Troy Reich also a floor spacer kasi. Sean Anthony's proven he's got that outside shot now. Troy Reich hasn't proven it on the PBA stage, of course, but we've seen him. Meron kamay sa labas. So, let's see.
So, a possible lineup for Northport would be Robert Bolick. Sino gusto mo sa dos? Garvo? Shooter like Garvo Lanete, maybe?
Alam mo, ang hindi nag-pan out pa so far, pero it was just inside the PBA bubble. Si Short Shorts, the guy from Adamson. Manganti. Hindi pa natin nakita talaga because he was coming off an injury as well, if I'm not mistaken.
Yeah.
So, yun eh, may patutunayan din yun this coming year para dito sa Northport.
Bolik, pwedeng dos si Manganti, tres mo si Jamie Malonzo, cuatro mo si Sean Anthony, cinco mo si Greg Slaughter. That team could be good.
Yeah.
Be good.
And then Reich off the bench, di ba?
Yep.
Yung Malonzo, at that Lord young be. Age, I want to see if he can bring that instant impact. He's got the talent. He's got the length. Let's see if we can hang with it. They're only going to have 10 scrimmage days. That's the thing. With all your God-given talent, if you only have 10 scrimmage days before we actually open, baka mahirapan ng rookies, lalo na yung younger rookies. Kaya marami tayo seasoned rookies. Eh. Mga hinug na for the PBA. But I'm all for having younger guys in the PBA. I'm all for guys na taking that risk and making that jump early. Hopefully lang, dahil if you had a full off season, no problem. Pero dahil nga hindi ganun kahaba yung off-season, 10 scrimmage days kalaunan, let's see what happens. Should be exciting times.
Napaaga dahil walang NCAA, walang UAAP, everyone advanced their plans to be able to help their families. Of course, naiintindihan din natin yung pangangailangan na yan. No? May tanong dito si John Vincent Estrella, si Tyus Hill daw, formerly from Adamson and then from LaSalle, bakit hindi na-draft? I don't think he completed his papers.
Yeah.
Kaya wala siya dun sa final list.
He was part of the 97 but not of the 86.
Yep. So
yun yun eh. Guess some of the guys completed their papers, some didn't. Yun lang yun eh. Diba?
And then Magua, the 12th pick. For me, the biggest surprise of the first round, because itong mga pangalan 1 to 11, you would have picked them to be in the first round. A lot of them, maybe 10 of them. Pero yung Ken Holmquist, I think, was a surprise for a lot of people.
We've been mentioning it. We haven't seen these guys play in a while because of the pandemic nga and all that. Matagal na natin di sila nakikita mag-compete ng live. Ito talagang bihira nakakita. Ako, honestly, I don't have that big a clue of how this guy plays, but that's Coach Tim Cone. He's probably seen enough when it comes to his scouting videos, scouting tapes. Yung back-to-back picks din, kahit pagdating natin sa second round, hindi kilala masyado. Tandaan din natin kasi. Binawasan din yung papers ng Philams. That's a must. It has to be there. Everybody's done it through the years. Mula nung 2000s na nagkagulo-gulo nun. May mga nakaka-comply, may nakaka-hindi. Pero the rules are there para nga sigurado na pulido, siguradong merong roots sa Pilipinas. Ang binawasan ng PBA ngayon is yung PBA D-League requirement. Yun yung isang nawala. Eh, dun din tayo tumututok, Carlo, di ba? Kaya pag na-assign tayo sa D-League, tuwan-tuwa tayo dahil iba yung nanonood ka sa bahay, iba yung nanonood ka sa stands, iba yung nanonood kang ikaw yung nag-cover, kompleto ka with the stats man and everything, and the slow, di ba? Slow-mo replay and all that. Mas natututukan natin, mas nahihimay natin laro ng mga players. This guy, I think a lot of people were surprised because a lot of people are unfamiliar with him, me included.
So, sabi ni Coach Tim Cone, he's looking for another big understudy ni Joe DeVance. Marami rin nagsasabi na, teka, ito ba yung future Bo Hawkins role for Alaska nung back in the day for Coach Tim Cone? Again, you don't expect Ken Holmquist to play a lot of minutes moving forward because you have Chapet Aguilar, you have Christian San Hardinger, and you have the most improved player of last season in Prince Caperal. So there will be limited minutes available for this young gun. So there's a lot of time for him to learn the ropes in the PBA.
May isa pa. Arthur De La Cruz. Coming off an injury din, ito na sana yung breakout niya doon sa loob ng bubble, pero ito yung sinasabing matagal ng understudy ni Joe DeVance. Ba't si Joe DeVance hindi niyo pag-initan at pag-retire rin? Ba't si Revis lang? Pero di ba, Joe DeVance is still effective, like you said, yep. Carlo. And then, he's got an understudy there as well. And doon pa si Arthur De La Cruz. We expect a lot more from Arthur this coming season.
Arvin Tolentino is another guy.
Yung pa isa, oo. Nagpakita din niya.
Medyo masagip yung magiging rotation ng big. So, if you're Ken Holmquist, put in the work, put in the time on the practice floor, and surely you will be able to break into the rotation given an opportunity. Moving on now with...
Reminder to both... Ikaw nagbanggit eh. Holmquist. Papraktisin pa lang natin yan. And to Brian Enriquez, itong susunod natin. From the second round, the first pick, Brian Enriquez. We gotta remind them, Scotty Thompson, it took him till the third conference to earn the trust of Coach Tim.
Uh-huh.
First two conferences, panaka-naka ang minutes yan. Third conference na siya nabigyan ng pagkakataon talaga. And nakita naman natin yung pinakita niya. So, like Carlo said, you have to put the work in.
First pick of the second round, Northport initially owned it, nakuha ng Barangay Ginebra by letting go of Jeric Balanza, and they used it to pick up Brian Enriquez, who was supposed to play for the UA Red Warrior, a tall guard, US pedigree. Not a lot is known about Brian Enriquez dahil nga hindi pa natin siya nakikitang maglaro, but in one workout with Barangay Ginebra, Coach Tim Cone was impressed enough to use that pick for him. So that speaks volumes of the potential nitong player na to.
And you know that's why they traded for that pick.
Mm-hmm.
Alam na eh. Siyempre, before a draft, maraming kumbaga sa baraha tatago mo lang. Kumbaga sa poker di mo papakita, pero magtataka yung mga iba bakit ka nagmo-move up ng ganito. Why did TNT go for the number 4 pick? Why did Ginebra go for the number 13 pick? May plano na yan eh. Coach Tim knew something. He wanted to be in that position na masisigurado niyang bukas pa. Available pa rather. And yun na nga napanood natin. Coach Tim going for this virtual unknown dahil nga hindi nga nakalaro sa UE.
Tapos Magu, yung pinakamalaking panggulat in the second round, Ray Mark Acuno landing with Blackwater Bossing. Tinitingnan ko si Coach Nash nung after nung pick, parang basag lahat ng mock draft nyo. Ganun yung itsura ni Coach Nash eh. Natawa pa nga siya nung binanggit natin yun eh.
Pero tingin mo, ano naman ang nakita ni Coach Nash dito kay Acuno?
Well, Coach Nash really wanted to add size. Yung importante sa kanya is to add size and defensive minded players. Para sa kanya sobrang importante 'yun, no? Athleticism is also there for Acuno. Same with Joshua Torralba, no? Alam natin the career nitong si Joshua Torralba did not really pan out well with La Salle, but if you ask yung mga players na nakatapat niya, they all respect his defense. And I think that will be what Coach Nash Asela is banking on, will be banking on as he welcomes him to the Blackwater Bossing.
Speaking of not panning out, ang pupunuan na lang pwesto dyan, yung hindi nag-pan out last season, yung Mauricio.
Mm-hmm.
They took him with a second overall pick, di ba? Yeah. Yun nga po ang draft, sugal yan eh. You take somebody with a pick that high, but he showed up to the bubble out of shape and had back problems all throughout. Ang question kasi ngayon doon, pinaka-importante, he was the oldest draft pick last year at 35, 36. So kung 35 siya noon, 36 to 37 na ngayon. So alam naman natin pag nagkakaedad, mas nahihirapang mag-recover from especially back problems. Napakabigat niyan. Hindi makakapag-workout yung the rest of your body. Kung may problema ka sa binte o sa paa, makakapag-upper body ka. Kung upper body problema mo, at least makakapag-cardio ka. Pag back problems, higa. Higa ka lang dyan, di ba? So, Coach Nash, moving on from Mauricio, from that pick. Mauricio, with all due respect, he's got a chance to prove himself ngayong magiging second year na niya sa PBA. Let's see how that pans out. Pero itong Blackwater, bukod sa nagpalit na ng pangalan officially to Bossings, masusubukan nila ngayon itong mga pick nila. Let's see how they will get the opportunity. Yun ang maganda doon.
And I also heard, Maguna, hindi naman garantisado na mabibigyan ng roster spot sa NLEX itong si Mauricio. Ah. So let's see what will happen in the future. Kasi ang dami ring players nung NLEX.
You've got guys like Soyud and Kinyahan still there, di ba? Magat, nandoon pa. So, yeah.
So maraming bigs yung NLEX and sobrang dami nilang players that signed. I mean, even before the draft, they already had a lot of players signed into new contracts. Pati yung ibang mga practice player na hindi nakasama sa bubble actually got new contracts from the NLEX management. And then they picked up a lot of names as well dito sa ating draft. So let's see what the lineup would look like in the future for the Road Warriors. We get a couple of shooters back-to-back for Alaska and Rainer Shine, Taylor Brown again, and Frankie Johnson. If you're able to get confident scorers like Taylor Brown and Frankie Johnson in the second round, yun yung magpapakita sa'yo na iba yung lalim nitong draft na to, Magu.
Yung Frankie Johnson, ang question lang is, kaya ba niya yung physicality sa PBA? Okay, 3x3 is physical. And he did have success in that league, in that world. Pero iba pa rin yung sa PBA. Iba yung day in, day out. Iba yung grind ng PBA. And especially with the quality of guards. Tanda naman natin, sa guards, wala ka talagang panapon dito sa Pilipinas. Eh. Philippine Basketball, the Philippine Basketball Association, sobrang siksikan, sobrang competition ng mga gwardya natin. Dahil karamihan naman talaga sa atin, pang-gwardya ang size, di ba? Kaya nagiging special pag lumampas ka na ng 6'3", 6'4", 6'5". Eh. So, we'll see how that pans out para dito sa Rain or Shine. Alaska, Coach Jeff Carriazo said, he got everybody he wanted. Everybody he was targeting at their positions was available, and he is excited and he is pumped up with who they got.
Sarap marinig nun, no, Magu, from your head coach heading into that team na ikaw talaga yung tina-target nila. That should just give itong si Adamos and itong si Taylor Brown a lot of confidence heading into their first season in the PBA, knowing na may plano talaga si Coach Jeffrey Carriazo for them, no? Moving forward to number 6.
Ito, parehong-pareho din. Sabi ni Coach Topex, hinabol talaga niya si Dick DeMusis. Pati si Aljun Melesio, nakuha din ni Coach Topek. So it just becomes different. Ano? It puts it in a different light when the coach was actually eyeballing you. Uh-huh. And then you fall into his lap. Hindi yung, okay, kunin natin to kahit di tayo masyadong tiwala, hindi masyadong kilala. Ito yung hinahanap talaga na baka saktong-sakto ka eh. Baka piece of the puzzle ka eh, no?
And yung maganda dito, kanina mag-u sinabi ko sa'yo, I would have been really interested to see Alvin Pasaol playing for Phoenix. Now, he may not be an Alvin Pasaol, but he could definitely play a role similar to Alvin Pasaol Moses. No, he has a size, he is athletic, he's a hard worker. And then you add a point guard behind itong si Chris Banchero, who will be debuting for them in the Philippine Cup, in Aljun Melesio. So, really good additions for the Fuel Masters at this stage.
Sumunod na pick naman dyan, itong sa NLEX, and you talked about it. They stacked up. They've got a lot of guys. Dave Morel, how do you like that pick for Coach Ang?
Good athleticism coming from UP. Smart player. Alam mo si Coach Yang, naghahanap yan ng mga players who can do a lot of things on both ends of the floor. He already has a talent. Eh. He has Kevin Alas, Kiefer Ravena is also there. Si Mike Ayon-Ayon showed brilliance in the PBA bubble. So in terms of scoring, hindi ganun kalaking problema for the Road Warriors. But he's looking for those versatile guards. And David Morales could crack that lineup, actually.
Next up, ito pinaka-excited ako. I think kinapiright ba ni Kuya Mico Halili to? Pero this is a Kuya joke. Eh. Stockton, Alex Stockton. Going to Alaska. Ang tagal-tagal-tagal na natin pangarap, Carlo, na makakuha ng import naman na Stockton ang apelido ang kahit sinong team sa PBA. Para lang pagkal na may bad na, Stockton to Malone. Pag ito, hindi ako inasay ni Direk Julius Melo. Alaska game. Sign mo ako, hindi ako umihiling ng game, alam mo yun, kahit saan niyo ako lagay. Ngayon, hihiling ako. Isa lang. Isang maagang Alaska game. Kung pwede yung first.
Bata pa ako, joke na yan eh.
pero sana gamitin, no? Inassign ka nga ni Junesty namang ginamit to si Malone, si Stockton. Si Malone tuloy, mali.
Yan. Wala pa man, nalilito ka na kay Alex Stockton. He knows his role. Yan yung maganda kay Alex Stockton eh. Alam niya kung anong klaseng player magiging, kung anong magiging siya sa PBA. He is a defender. He is a lockdown defender. And he will be guarding the best scorers from the other teams. That will be his role. And you have to give him credit kasi siya lang yata yung nakabarong dun sa buong PBA draft. No? Siya lang yung nag-formal talaga. He dressed up for the occasion, wore a barong as we saw in that Zoom call.
Up next will be number 10 of the second round of Rain or Shine. This one I'm really looking forward to. Hindi dahil yung tatay niya ay batang Kang Kalu. Ito kasi nakita natin yung game. Anton Asistio, yung batang to, pwede mo nga sabihin Von Pesumal 2.0. Eh. The guy can shoot from anywhere, any angle from that three-point arc. He's got some slashing. He's got a decent defense. Ang problema lang, he's only 5'10". That's the only drawback with Anton Asistio.
Oh, nga. But Anton is a hard worker, high basketball IQ. So, yeah. Alam din natin yung Rain or Shine, kailangan ng Guardia Magu. Kaya yung mga additions nilang yan, Anton Asistio, Andre Caracot, they should be able to get minutes for Coach Chris Gavina because they're really looking for talents in that spot. May comment dito, sorry, natawa lang ako, Magu. Kasi dati, alam mo yung pinapangarap ko na tandem sa PBA, maging magkakampi si Julian Sargent tsaka si Greg Slaughter.
Sergeant Slaughter.
Sabi ni Philip Ines, sabi niya, sana magkasama si Alex Stockton at saka si Jamie Malonzo. So Stockton to Malonzo.
Stockton to Malonzo. Pwede.
Palabiro itong mga 2-0 team natin. And then, Magu, the final draft selection of the second round, si Mark Olayon. So, I would like to apologize to Mark Olayon kasi alam ko buong buhay mong pinangarap yung madraft sa PBA. No? Tagal mong hinintay, pinaghirapan mo lahat ng basketball clinics, lahat ng laro na ginawa mo, training, practice, paulit-ulit from grade school to college to be drafted into the PBA. You waited for your moment. And then when you had your moment, dumaan ako sa harap mo. Interview kan Kyle Lizardo. Pasensya ka na, Marco Lion. Hindi ko sinasadya. Akala ko nasa Zoom call. Akala ko naka-focus sa iyo. Dumaan akong parang wala lang.
Jaywalking eh. Pwede mo ba i-share to, Gops? Ay, wag. May rights ba tayo? Still picture
tama
naman
na,
yun eh.
Tama na yung still. Okay na yung pa-picture
saka, picture ngayon. Saka mukha ni Carlo naman talaga yun eh. So, siguro may rights ka naman sa mukha mo. No?
Wala yun. Pasensya na. Hinintay ko talaga tumaguin. Tagal kong kinimkim. Ang tagal kong pinagdusahan. Gusto ko lang magpa-sorry talaga kay Mark Olayo na ninakaw ko yung kapirasong moment niya. So, promise, i-text ka namin. Pinul screen pa talaga. May message ka namin, gigess ka namin.
May jaywalking. Bawal sa MMDA yan. Magmapanatang makabayang ka. Sige ka.
Galit na galit siguro sa akin yung pamilya ni Mark Olayo. Eh, no? Ito na lang yung moment namin. Eh. Mati-TV kami ng maayos-ayos. Umabot kami sa second round kaya na-interview kami ni Carlo Lizardo. Tapos dinaanan ni Carlo Pamintuan. Hayop yan.
One of the highlights of the night, I think. But hindi kasi nakal ng floor director. Si ba FD mo, si Mike?
nakatalikod eh. So hindi na niya ako napagalitan.
Malamang si MSJ ang napagalitan.
Muntik atakihin yata nung ginawa ko yun, si MSJ. Mark Olayon, I hope to cover your games in the future. Good luck sa'yo. Sana umabot ka sa roster ng Northport. Kasi pag naglaro ka for the first time, at least alam kong nakabalik ka sa TV, umere ka sa TV 5, so hindi na ako masyadong magigilty. Pero ngayon, guilty pa rin ako mag-u.
Mahirap pa ka bumawi. So yan po yung first two rounds, every single pick. Ngayon, pasadahan natin from round 3 onwards, Carlo. Yung mga notables natin, unahin natin. First pick of the third round, best friend ni Sedel Tupas. Shout out, CPT.
Reverente na talagang inabangan ni Sedef Tupas ang pagkakadraft niya sa PBA. May comment ka pa ba, Magu? Ayokong ma-MTRCB eh.
Move on tayo.
Plus Lauren Brill with Northport. Pero ito, Blackwater Air Bossing.
I absolutely love this pick.
Yep.
I was looking at Andre Paras to go maybe late second round, mid to late second round. At least dito, early in the third round, Andre Paras. Dom and Coach RG were saying it. Merong ibang stigma. It's both a blessing and a curse, I guess, to be the son of one of the greatest ever. The only rookie MVP in the history of the PBA. The most dominant force in the 90s in the PBA, in the early 90s at that. Benji Paras, of course, idol natin, Tower of Power, two-time MVP, national team player. Pero sabi nga ni Dom and ni RG, he's just got to keep in mind, he's not his father, he's not his brother. Dahil syempre, well, celebrated din naman si Kobe Paras. Pero this kid, he has put the work in. There was a time there na napansin ko parang hindi na basketball yung number one priority niya. And I think we all noticed that around the basketball community. Mm-hmm. Pero nagkaroon ng shift eh. Nagkaroon ng pagbabalik, pre-pandemic to. In the PBA D-League, let's remind everybody, this kid was pulling down 20 rebounds a game, 25 rebounds a game. Yep. He was being a presence in there. He's not gonna give you 30 points a game. Pero ito si Andre Paras, you know, kasama si Idol Benji. Yung hard work nando doon, and he, while it might be a curse na may pressure na Tower of Power kasi airpods mo, that can also be a chip on his shoulder to prove to everybody na sandali. Kaya kong makipaglaban dito, kaya kong patunayan na kaya niya makipagsabayan on this stage, Carlo.
And yung gusto ko rin dyan, nakita ko yung IG story nung kapatid niya, no, si Kobe Paras. We all know he's an outstanding basketball player, Kobe Paras. But he was celebrating his brother's moment. Hindi, kahit third round yan, he celebrated it like, you know, it was the first round. Masaya lang siya na na-draft yung kapatid niya. It was just absolute pure joy coming from that family to see Andre Paras possibly getting an opportunity to play dun sa liga na nilaruan ng tatay nila. So, congratulations, Andre Paras. Hopefully, we get to see you in the PBA.
Anong sumunod sa Tower? overpass. overpass of power.
sabi mo nga kanina, hindi siya si Benji, so iwasan na lang natin completely yung mga Tower of Power dahil let Andre be Andre.
Alam mo, nadagdag ni para sa ano niya. And eto ha, pwede na naman niya paglaban din yung stigma. Merong certain, in certain basketball circles, Carlo, pagka Tisoy malambot daw o hindi kaya makipagbanggaan, pakalitan na mukha. Pinatunayan na yan ni Rodney Brondial din naman. Ni Mark Pingris, napatunayan na yan. Patay kung patay type of basketball. Paras might be, Andre Paras might be in the same mold. Yun nga, binabanggit natin numbers niya from the PBA D-League. Hopefully, that translates into the PBA. We don't expect 25 rebounds. We don't expect him to have that many minutes to begin with. But because of what hard work he will put in, hopefully, kung maglaro siya ng 10 minutes, humugot din ng 8 boards, 7 boards, ando doon yun. Just be a presence, play a role. One guy you never have to call up play for, never needs the ball, but he will be effective. And may 3-point shooting na, just like Brondial. May shooting na sa labas ngayon.
Magu, three names that I think will get the opportunity to play for their respective teams mula dito sa third round. I'll start with Ronnie De Leon of Magnolia. Dahil nga hindi sila kumuha ng big in the first round, they decided to go with Jerick Ahanmisi. I think he might get a chance to make the roster para to have an extra body there in practice, try to develop him, itong si De Leon from UE. I like the pick of RK Ilagan for Alaska. Getting to learn from JV Castro. Of course, he's another very intelligent guard. Napakatalino nitong si RK Ilagan.
One drawback kay Ilagan, I think he's listed at 5'7".
Yes.
There have been 5'7" guys in the PBA in the past, but it's going to take somebody special to crack a lineup and last in the PBA if you're that short.
And the other player na tingin ko baka makalusot sa lineup is Raymar Kaduyak of Phoenix. Mm. That connection, syempre, kay Coach Topex Robinson. Paulit-ulit kong sinasabi, no? In the PBA D-League, Magu, when they won the title as Zarks, yung tumapos dun sa do or die game, hindi si CJ Perez, hindi si MJ Ayaay, hindi yung Twins, yung tumapos sa laro si Raymar Kaduyak. He took over in that end game. So, you can't teach that kind of trust between a coach and a player, and they already have it.
And tawag din yung clutch gene. You yep. can't teach clutch. It's somebody who is willing to take that responsibility and deliver. Yun yan. Kaya naman talagang yung tiwala na. Kumbaga dati nga may tiwala na eh. Lalo pa napatunayan on that level. D-League eh. Nag-deliver ka pa rin. Moving on to the fourth round. Meron ng isang team na nagpass sa third round. Dito sa fourth round, dalawang team na nagpass. Nadagdagan ng isa rather. Hinebra passed in the third. Alaska passed in the fourth. Sino ang tingin mong may pinakamagandang opportunity magpakilala dito?
I'm sa sampu. At this point, I'm not sure. Pero nakita na natin ginawa ni Jun Manso. Unfortunately for him, maraming gwardiya yung Blackwater. How will they carve space for Jun Manso? They may be able to do it. But at this point, from the fourth round on, I'm not sure if we'll see anyone crack the roster heading into the upcoming season.
So fifth round, as we move on, we see two more teams pass in this round. Pero ang pinakamatunog dito, Carlo,
mm-hmm.
yung Jerry Pingoy falling all the way down to the fifth round. This kid, he's been much talked about around the basket. Hindi buong Pilipinas, pero yung basketball community for the past decade or so, mm-hmm. Close to a decade, matunog na yung pangalang Jerry Pingoy. Coach Topex was a fifth-round pick back in his day, back in 2001. And alam naman natin nangyari kay Coach Topex. Naging, hindi tayo OA na 25 greatest, 50 greatest, 40 greatest. But Coach Topex made a name for himself. He had his own style and nagtagal din siya sa PBA. He's giving this kid a chance right now, Carlo.
Yeah, yep. Si Jerry Pingoy, you can say that he was a victim of some of the decisions that he made throughout his basketball career. I'm sure looking back, he would have done things a little differently. Alam natin saan siya nanggaling no high school, transferred to Ateneo, landed with Adamson. Hindi nag-pan out eh. At every level, yung potential that people saw that was possible for him in high school never panned out in college. So will he finally get the chance to display yung ano talaga yung kaya niyang gawin and do that in the PBA no less? I think Coach Topex Robinson, like, you know, like Coach Yang Yao will be able to give him the chance. But it's all a matter of makaka-pwesto pa ba siya? Will he have a spot in that lineup?
I think the last guy who got a chance like this, if I'm not mistaken, ano lang naman sa akin lang, the guy from La Salle na nasa Cebu, yung anak ni Talyo.
Mm.
Di ba? Yung ang gulo din, hindi din nag-pan out ng ganong kaswabe yung kanyang college playing days. Pero was still given a chance to get to the next level. Hindi nga lang dinagtagal after that.
TNT. I think it was TNT. And Lex, I think, signed him. But as you said, Magu, didn't pan out. Because itong si Jerry Pingo, you can just see the raw emotions. No, sila actually ni Carl Brian Ravanes yung paborito kong reaction dun sa buong draft. Si Ravanes kasi gulat na gulat that he was selected by Northport. Si Pingo is overcome with emotions when he was picked by Phoenix. So you just want to get a foot in the door. And that's what's happening in the fourth round and the fifth round. That is at the very least an invitation to join them in practice. And then maybe get to perform and then maybe get to sign. Pero they're going through a very difficult process para makapunta sa PBA.
Moving on to the sixth round, same thing. Yung sabi mo nga, fourth round, fifth round, ngayon, sixth round, we're gonna go through hanggang sa eight. Di na kailangan isa-isa yan. Pero once you're in these picks, like what Carlos has been mentioning, lalong-lalo na, just to re-emphasize or mas na-magnify ngayon, hindi tayo nag-D-League. Walang college basketball. Wala ring ibang liga. So, hindi ka nga nakikita eh. O kung nakita ka naman o nabalitaan ka man, that was a long time ago. O may mga YouTube clip ka man or highlights. Iba yung fresh eh. How are you playing now? How's your conditioning now? All of these guys, they get the dream come true of having your name called. Mm-hmm. Pero once you're round four and beyond, the work is just beginning. Yep. Especially magnified now na ang tagal na nga mula nung huli ka nakita. Yun yung ano dun eh, di ba?
Some of these guys we still saw in the PBA D-League. Itong si El Medrab, I remember him being the biggest player dun sa team niya. No? I think he also lost a bit of weight preparing for the PBA draft. Maybe pwede siya magpakita for Northport as we move on to the next rounds. Yung Northport talaga yata yung pinakamaraming nakuha
player.
Na malengke talaga. Itong Northport, napagod yata sa kaka-announce si Sean Anthony. Kasi ang dami niyang nasabing pangalan. Ito, round 7, still picking up. Round 8, may isa pa yata silang nakuha, if I'm not mistaken. I think they were the last team to pass, Magu.
Yeah. Northport making Jonathan Mendoza the final pick of the 46th PBA draft. 65 players got picked. I think that's a record. Kaya sinisigurado ni Boss Comwilly na tama yung bilang eh. Dahil sandali, ito na yung pinakamarami atang na-pick. Hopefully, all of these guys, you all know already, first rounders, almost sure ball. Second rounders, almost sure ball. Third round, makikipaglaban. Fourth round and beyond, the work begins. Hopefully, lahat eh mag-pan out, everybody na napili na maaga, eh magpakita at patunayan na yung tiwalang binigay sa kanila by picking them, nandoon naman o hindi masayang. Tapos ito mga gustong magpakilala talaga kahit sa ensayo lang muna, talagang magkaroon naman ng pagkakataon. At least ipakilala yung sarili nila. Kasi tandaan din natin, even if you don't make that 15-man lineup, merong 3x3. 4-man, 5-man lineup ang 3x3, Carlo.
5-man.
5-man lineup. So yung PBA nga, pinapalawak palalo yung liga to give everybody an opportunity. And as you said, Carlo, this draft class may just change the landscape.
Magu, as we wind down in this episode, we thank Leonard Sandilian for joining us earlier. We thank everyone for sticking with us, no? Kanina, 150 yung nanonood, 100 right now. Dumalang yung episodes namin ni Magu. We had to take a break for a little bit.
Kasi masyadong busy si Carlo, maming ka na.
Busy. Dito lang sa bahay. We missed you. We missed talking to everyone, yung ating 2-0 team, syempre. But moving forward after the draft, we will do our best to hang out with you as often as we can. Sabi nga namin, kikilalanin natin karamihan sa mga nakapasok na rookies. We will try to, you know, bring you the latest news. Kasi Magu, yung importante ngayon, the next stage of the PBA would be everyone filling out their rosters.
Yun.
Yung mga papipirmahin na free agents, rookies ba yan, or will this be veterans switching to other teams because they were released by their former teams? Yan yung mga hinihintay nating balita, no? And we will be covering all of that, and we will make sure nakasama kayo sa ating mga conversations dito sa 2OT.
Yun yung next step para sa PBA, para matuloy yung season. Tayo naman, next step natin, bisa kahapon, di ba? As much as possible, kaya nga nakakapagkwento na naman tayo at hindi masyado busy si Carlo, stay at home ulit tayo. Kasi pagka lahat tayo, karamihan sa atin, nag-stay at home talaga, yung mga hindi naman kailan lumabas, makakatulong tayo to reduce what is going on out there. At pagka bumaba na po yan, kapag ka nag-stable na po at hindi na namamagana naman yung mga infection sa labas, matutuloy yung liga natin. Diba? We all have to do our part para lahat tayo makapanood na ulit ng Philippine basketball.
Magu, isa pa sa mga pwede natin gawin is not to eat out. So, order na muna kayo ng pagkain. And that note, Cheap Pop, Mia Kali, maraming salamat.
Uy! Mia Kay!
Best beer tacos in town.
Mexican, yun nga, Mexicans yan. Yung Mexican, ano, Taco yeah. Tuesday ni Mia ka.
Yep, nag-order ako kanina. Salamat sa pagluluto at pagpapadala.
Saan yan? Sa Instagram? Paano sinasearch? Oh,
message mo lang. Si Mia
ano yung... Aka niya ka mismo. Oh, walang sariling page. Baka may sariling page.
Dish MNL yung pangalan. Dish MNL.
Ah.
Thank you, Miaka. Padalan mo kami minsan ni Magu para makain namin sa show.
Yan.
Tsaka shout out sa Gatorade.
And syempre sa mga kaibigan natin sa Smart.
Siyempre.
Smart pa rin naman tayo eh, di ba?
Palagi naman yan.
Namimiss ko na yun, ha? Smart kami ni Carlo.
Soon. And on that note, maraming salamat po sa lahat ng nanood dito sa ating mumunting episode, Leonard Santillan, and our breakdown of the 46th PBA Gatorade Rookie Draft. For Magu Marjon, ako po si Carlo Pamintuan. See you again next time here on 2OT.